Overhand kick. We'll be taken on a bounce at the 17. It's Mike Miller, breaks a tackle, takes it up the sideline, a spin move, takes it up to about the 39-yard line. That's where the Bobcats will start. First and 10, Bobcats. Running backfield is in place. Dale Abbott, who hurt his thumb last week, is also playing. He's at right end. Well, the Bobcats seem to have their full complement, and Nate Dutal gets his first carry in a couple weeks and gets bent over very often. Second down and 8, Bobcats from their own 41-yard line. Dutal again, picking his way, breaking tackles, first down and more. Prior to that, he had 5 straight 100-yard games. On first and 10 from the 47 of Kingswood, it's Chucky Reed getting his first carry and picking up a couple of yards. And a lot of them out here to say thank you to Coach Lenihan today also. Second down and 8, Bobcats ready, getting to the line of scrimmage as Acker still now just makes his way off the field. Ready to go, Dutile and Reed in the backfield, strong side left. This is Chucky Reed getting a quick hitter up the middle and again picking up just a couple yards.
Seems odd, Brian,
down 5, Plymouth from the 41-yard line of Kingswood. Just underway here, first quarter. Dutile hit at the line, a great tackle there made by Kingswood's Jeff Hurt Tottenham. This is the punter. Gets a good snap, good blocking up front. Gets off a high kick. They're going to let it go. Takes a Plymouth bounce. It will be down at about the 7-yard line. It landed at the 5 and took a Plymouth bounce. Did not roll into the end zone. So Kingswood will be pinned back at about their 7 or 8-yard line. All at the 8. First down there. Allie Skelly. Alan Dahlberg knew I was going to do that. Doug Skelly is the quarterback. I formation. Toss to the halfback. And good run here. Big hole across the 15. Up to about the 18-yard line, close to first down yardage. That was the halfback. Is that Ricky Eaton?
Looked like 16, but it must have been.
16 is Sawyer, Brad Sawyer.
It wasn't him. Oh, that's right, they changed them. There would be
an inch or two. So gain of 9 for Brad Sawyer. Bob, they made a couple of nice real nice plays right there in the line of scrimmage, the front 4. Second and short, high formation for the Knights. Doug Skelly turns hands to the fullback, and ball is loose, or is it? No? Got pushed back. I don't think he got it. I think he lost a yard or two. He lost a yard. That was the fullback, Jeff. Calagandis, thank you. And it's going to be third down in a yard. They've done a great job, Nate Dutile and Bruce McKay, the linebackers, on third down and short. Brad Sawyer, they split backfield, and now Skelly doesn't like something that he sees and calls a timeout. And instead of running back, he will be in the backfield this time, and it'll be Sawyer going out to a split position right. Calagandis, the fullback, they toss to Eaton. Eaton has a first down, breaking tackles, nearly broke that for a big one. Tottenham, I think it was, or McKay, one of the others, saved a touchdown perhaps. Field with Calagandis. Tatro split wide right, I formation on first down and 10. Skelly wants to throw. Here comes the rush. Tottenham has him. Down he goes. It was Dale Abbott that almost got him. He really forced the play, and Tottenham came in and picked up the pieces and sets up a second down of 17. I formation, Skelly toss. This is Sawyer looking for running room, no place to go. Stevie Thompson, this was there to force the play, and he got plenty of help. Nate Fish here for the Kingswood Knights. Line of scrimmage is back at their own 13. Split backfield this time. They come with a counter play to Sawyer. Forget about it. Chucky Reed staying at home, making a big play. Another 3-yard loss. And it'll be fourth and about 22 yards to go. Sawyer, the punt, just got that away and shanked it. Goes out of bounds at about the Plymouth, rather the Kingswood 15. No, he's still down to the 14-yard line. The line of, that's what, about a two-yard punt? If that, right, Dwayne? I think the line of scrimmage was about the 11. 6:14 to go, first quarter, no score. First down and 10, Bobcats at the Kingswood 13. Quick hitter to Dutile. Again, finding the going really rough inside. It looked like number 78, McClutchy. On second down and 8. Chucky Reed, left side, cuts it. Inside the 5, touchdown, Chucky Reed. 11-yard touchdown run for Chucky Reed. The Bobcats are on the board. Chucky Reed has really stepped up his game in the absence of Nate Dutile in recent weeks. In fact, he's caught him the extra point. And Grant Wagner's kick sails clear through the middle of the uprights. Plymouth leads it 7-0. We have had great weather this year here. Yeah, we have. That's why we're very. Last week in Monadnock, 2 years before we go back, so maybe we'll keep our fingers crossed. Grant Wagner toeing to the football. Short kick, high kick, taking it to 15. This is Tatro, takes it up the middle to the 30. And Matt Fish, 74 there for a solo tackle, breaking the wedge. And they'll mark it at the 31. That's where Kings will start, first and 10. Coverage 31, not too bad. You know, I'm sure Kings will take it as well. Sawyer split wide left. He'll be lining up against the sophomore Miller. I formation, fullback gets the call and gets nothing. Absolutely nothing. Runs into a swarm of Bog, gets the play after each play is over. And that's Doug Skelly, the sophomore quarterback. He'll line his team up in the I formation. Sawyer split wide right. Seems like Miller's going wherever he goes. The tailback. This is Eaton. Gets the yardage back. It was lost on the previous play. And they've only tried once, and he was sacked on that attempt. So it's going to be tough for young Mr. Skelly this afternoon. We'll never forget a play here last year, Dwayne, in that first round of the playoffs, where his older brother got laid out down here to the left side of the field. They were trying to drive for the winning touchdown. I think that was that McKay that got him that year. He's back to pass. Here comes Abbott. Down he goes. The ball came loose. I don't know if they're going to rule it down, but Abbott just buried Skelly all the way back at the 15. That's a loss of 16 yards on that sack. And they obviously can't get him on the line either. Sawyer to punt, standing back at about his 1 yard line. Charlie Bork, Justin Gray, back to receive it. Gets off a better punt this time, not a great one. Takes a bounce, so Bobcats will let it roll out of bounds at about the 47-yard line of Kingswood. Bobcats take over first and 10. You heard it again last week. Takes a breather. And on first down, play action. Diamond looking, throwing. He's got Hanley. First down. Had to go to a knee to get it. The ball was a little bit behind him, or that could have been 6 points. But they will take the first down. Gain of about, 11 yards on the play. Dutile and Chucky Reed are in the backfield. First down and 10 from the 34-yard line. Chucky Reed gets a block from Dutile. Well, that's not Dutile, but he gets a great block there. Good block, and picks up pretty good yardage inside the 30 down to about the 28-yard line. Nice block by Bonacolto, pulling from the left guard position that time. Reed cuts it inside. Gets about 4 yards, it looks like, 3-4 yards. Maybe a little bit shy of the first down. First down, Bobcats at the 24-yard line of Kingswood. Already up 7-0. Down to 2 minutes to go here, and a rapidly moving head coach here at Plymouth Regional High School. That'll happen at the Plymouth Elks Lodge on Route 175 in Holderness after today's game. Dutile trying to turn the corner. Can't. Nice tackle by Tatro. He needed to cut that up. He got the block he needed from Chucky Reed. Needed to cut that one up. Tried to turn the corner. He does have good speed, but he couldn't outrun Tatro that time. About 2 yards, I guess. It'll be second down and 8. State straight drop for Diamond. Looking, he's got Dutile on a screen. And cuts it up and gets down to the 15, a little bit shy of the first down, get about six. And very close to getting a clipping call on Chucky Reed there. That one was very much on the edge. The officials didn't call it. So it'll be third and a couple, third and two. From about the 14, pitch to Reed. He's got plenty of room to pick up the first down, and does. Picks up four down to the 10, maybe even five down to the nine. They'll call it four, first down and goal. First down and goal. Dutile and Reed in the backfield, strong side right. Charlie Bork at the wing over there. Dutile gets a brush block from Reed, gets down to the five, six maybe. Gain of four. Second down and goal. And we have played one quarter of football here at the George Lewis Field at Plymouth Regional High School. The score is the Bobcats 7, Kingswood nothing. We'll be back with the second quarter in just a moment. Of Kingswood, Plymouth up 7-0. Trying to tack on more. Bobcats looking to go 7-0 on the season. Got Mike Miller in the backfield this time. He'll get the toss and get hit in the backfield. That was Tacho. He saw that one coming. He'll lose 6-7 yards. Third down and goal from the 13-yard line. Passing situation. Chucky Reed returns to the backfield, but they give it to Reed. Reed can just break a tackle. Gets inside the 10, down to about the 8-9-yard line. So he got four. Let's see, he got five, but it's going to be fourth down. Yep. 25 yards from the right hash mark for Grant Wagner. Good snap, good hold. Kick, I think, missed left. Missed.
Sorry for that air.
10:42 to go here. First half, I formation. Caligandis gets the call, gets around the right end, and gets up to the 29-yard line. Finally driven out of bounds there by Shane Tower, but a good gain. Almost a first down, probably a few inches short.
Yeah, Chuck just got hung up on the corner, got tangled up in a block, just lined up.
Well, looks like they want to measure this, but it's right in front of the sticks. And if the ball's not touching the 30-yard line, then it shouldn't be a first down. It's got to be a couple inches shy. I think they have. Nice hat, Dwayne.
Feels nice, but definitely nice.
Caligandis, the fullback, didn't get a lot, but powers ahead for two or three and a first down. First and 10. Kingswood, call it three. Line of Kingswood is our line of scrimmage here to start this next series of downs. Split backfield this time. This is Eaton. Forget about it. Kurt Tottenham in the backfield makes the tackle for a big loss all the way back to the 25. 17, 18 to go here now. Line of scrimmage is the 25. Tottenham was in there quick. I formation this time. Oh, Eaton with no place to go. He'll lose another yard. That's Nate Fish, 85, who sniped through to make the hit, but he's still on the ground. And they have third down and 19 facing them now from the 24-yard line. Skelly, they come with the end around to Sawyer. Now they toss it back to a linebacker, or I mean an offensive lineman. I don't know if that was the... it looked like a lateral. Wow. I don't know what you call that one, Dwayne. We'll give it to Sawyer.
Pessy must have been calling on the play.
The razzle-dazzle certainly didn't work. No. Sawyer standing back at his nine to punt the ball away on third and forever. Gets off a good kick this time. Gray takes his 49, drops it, falls on it at the Kingswood 49. So the Bobcats are a little fortunate there.
Except for that one early touchdown.
Yeah, way back at about the 12-yard line of Bobcats, when they do resume, they're going to have Hanley split out at left end. They're going to go to a little pro set here. Try to loosen things up. Audie is up on his feet and walking off under his own power. Trainer Darryl Charpentier. On first down and 10 from the Kingswood 49. Almost ready. Audie is almost off the field. And we're about ready to go. Plymouth up 7-0, 7.5 minutes to go. We're in the second quarter here at the George Zulius Field in Plymouth. Chucky Reed breaking tackles. And got nine. Boy, he had one more. If he could have gotten away from Tatro, he had a lot of grass in front of him. And all over the football all afternoon. Plays the right cornerback position. Second down and one. Bobcats at the 40-yard line of Kingswood. Reed again. Gets a nice block from Bonacolto. He's running free now. And we got a penalty marker down. I don't know where that one. It must have been on Jason Williams. Because Bonacolto laid a heck of a block, but that's coming back. At about 12, 13 yards, it'll be wiped out. And I believe that's a holding call, Dwayne. You see the indication? Boy, what a, that's twice Bonacolto from left guard. He's come out pulling and just laid a tremendous block to spring Chucky Reed. Now is the 48-yard line of Kingswood. Clock running with 6:40 to go here in the second quarter. Hanley goes split wide right. Charlie Bork setting the wing on the right side. They come with the counter to Bork. Bork looking to pick his way clean but can't. Good tackle made for Kingswood that time by number 9 to a game. Inside of 6 minutes to go here in this second quarter. Big third down play for the Bobcats. Dutile and Reed in the backfield. Quick hitter. Dutile, he's running free. He's got the first down all the way down near the 30-yard line. You got 15. Leading 7-0. Hanley wide left. Play action. Looking. He's got Abbott. Complete. Abbott down to about the 24-yard line. Be a gain of about 7 or so. Charlie Bork in the wing, left side. They give it to Dutile. Dutile cuts it up. Should have plenty for the first down. He does, because he has about 6 yards on that carry. First and 10, Bobcats, as again they press down at 10 from the 17. This is Miller pounding it up off of right tackle. Gets it down to the 15, gets two. Second down and 8. They sent Hanley split wide left on the second down and 8, and they give the ball to Reed. Reed has nowhere to go. Coming up to make a tackle that time, 15-yard line, just outside the 15. Big third down play again. Play action, Diamond looking, stops and throws, incomplete. I don't know where he was going with that one. Nobody there getting a hand on it was Chip McClutchie. And Grant Wagner comes on. This will be a longer one. This will be about a 32-yard attempt, again from the right hash mark. Missed his first attempt wide left. Bobcats letting opportunities slip away. Good snap, good hold. This kick looks good. It is. 32-yard field goal. The Bobcats push the lead to 10-0 with 3 minutes, 5 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Hello, the second quarter is being brought to you by the Ashland Insurance Agency for personal attention to your insurance needs. Back deep to receive this kick. Number three, Chris Brothers, a sophomore, 140-pounder. He's the middleman. Then it's Brad Sawyer. And Tetro, Josh Tetro, another sophomore. Look, that Josh Tetro, Dwayne, only a sophomore. He's looked pretty good today. Wagner, high kick, short kick, end over end. This is the short man, Brothers, that takes it. Looking to return it up the middle and gets buried at about the 31-yard line. Trailing the Bobcats 10-0. Homecoming for the Bobcats. A nice crowd here today across the way, and why not? Beautiful day to come out and watch a football game. A trainer coming out again. He's eating.